Hey Top Gun, welcome to my channel, and today we'll be having a special episode because today you will meet someone from my team of software engineers, that is Olga. She's got the same name as myself. Olga is a stellar natural language processing engineer and our lead NLP engineer, and today she will tell you what it actually means to be a NLP engineer, what they actually do, and what tasks and issues do they solve, what practical use does it have. So if you're interested in this profession, if you're interested to learn what it actually means, and if you would like to learn whether this profession could be applied to you, continue watching. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't and click the notification bell. And if you already have, click that like button and continue watching. I have to apologize in advance for the video quality of our Zoom call with Olga, because Olga is located in another city than myself and she works as same as myself, she works remotely. And hence we have to communicate via Zoom and my camera broke. So I have to use my inbuilt camera on my laptop, which is pretty lame. So I apologize in advance and hope you will enjoy the episode nonetheless.
Okay, so hi Olga, thanks for joining me today. I promise I won't detain you for too long from your duties. So thank you for joining me today.
Hi Olga.
Yeah. So Olga, could you please briefly describe what it actually means to be a natural language processing engineer, and what typical tasks does an NLP engineer solve? Like, for what practical use those tasks are being applied to? And just what in general, what does a natural language processing engineer do?
Okay. If speak briefly, NLP engineer is a human who combines technical knowledge with linguistic and try to do our application more intellectually. Such engineers working with natural language data and transforming this data into useful features, useful NLP technicals to machine learning algorithms. The most typical NLP tasks are part of speech tagging, name entity recognition, word sense disambiguation, sentiment analysis, topic modeling, information retrieval, machine translation, automatic summarization, etc. So this task can be used for finding similar texts, for spell checking, for intelligent web searching, chatbots, and many, many others.
Well, that's great. Yeah, I mean, chatbots are being very popular today, so that definitely should, well, I mean, it means a lot for the industry. And what are the skills that a natural language processing engineer should have? I mean, what kind of background does an NLP engineer should have? So skills, maybe background, I don't know, some sorts of education. What does he or she need?
It's a really difficult question. In my opinion, it will be better if a person has a technical background and after this receive linguistic knowledge, then controversy. NLP engineer must know one of the programming languages, for example, Python, has knowledge in statistical analysis, machine learning methods, and text representative techniques. So the mathematics background is very good and very important, and English and basic linguistic knowledge also.
And so does coding, I mean, being a good coder, is it a must?
Yes, nowadays, yes, I think.
Oh, now if one wants to be not only working with, I don't know, ontologies, but maybe with some machine learning techniques, then he or she needs coding, right?
Yes, of course.
Okay. And what practical steps should a person take in order to become an NLP engineer? Like, for example, if I would like to shift to this position and drop everything and become an NLP engineer, so what should I do in order to become an NLP engineer?
First of all, I would recommend to try to take a distance course on the Coursera and understand for you, do you want to work with language task or not?
It's time to back up.
Yes. It's an introduction course, course. After this, start to learn a program language and parallel read books about NLP tasks and algorithms.
Mm-hmm. I see. So well, I guess so it means there's a person should start researching, and of course some introductory course would be a must. I don't think that they cost much on Coursera. By the way, I've seen a course about like $50 an introductory course, I believe I've seen recently. So yes, and start researching, and maybe there are even some free resources. And
Yes, there are a lot of free resources of NLP in FutureLearn, such mm-hmm. Platform for distance courses and etc.
Now, a little bit of a personal question. So how did you actually end to be an NLP engineer? I mean, has your primary focus, how you actually ended up being in IT and how you ended up being an NLP engineer? Like, has it been your primary focus, or have you first started to dig in one direction and then all of a sudden decided to shift to natural language processing mm-hmm. issues? So how did you end up in this IT and this NLP direction?
I start to work in this area on the master level at my university, and my education has also helped me to start working in IT. So and all this time I work in NLP area and never regret it.
Okay, so, and what sort of education do you have?
Applied mathematics. It's my bachelor level. Uh-huh. And system analysis, it's a master level.
Okay, and you, because, well, some people might not know, you are a lecturer at Kharkiv University, right?
Yes, yes, National Technical University, Kharkiv.
Uh-huh, and what subjects do you, well, teach students?
My last subject were natural language processing, modeling in language modeling, yes, and web design and object-oriented programming. So that's all.
Well, that's all. I mean, that's all. Okay, yeah, I like it. And well, now a little bit, yeah, of a personal, more I believe sensitive question. Could you tell, well, because what people are always looking for when they try to explore whether or not they should take this profession is how much can an NLP engineer earn? And well, a side note here that we are speaking about Eastern European wages, and in other countries it may vary, but overall on an international market, like, what are the hourly rates of an NLP engineer? So how much does an NLP engineer earn?
I think it depends of company, yes, and maybe project also, but when I start to work in this area in private company, I received $1,000 per month. Mm-hmm. So it's a start salary.
For juniors.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I see. And then, I mean, it only depends on your seniority level, I believe, yes, and skills that you master in the process. Yeah, because on the international market now, the senior wages, again, it depends on the set of skills that you have. For some machine learning engineers, I mean, who have applied those machine learning techniques, they earn more, a little bit more, and those who are using mostly rule-based approaches, they earn a little bit less. Right.
Yes.
Yeah. So it depends. So for juniors, yeah, you start at the lowest wages and then you grow in the process. Again, it depends on hourly rates and on how much time you spend, whether you're working full time, part time, on an hourly basis. And yes, from my perspective, well, I've seen natural language processing engineers who earn like $5,000 per month. But again, that depends on all the skills you have and the seniority level in the company. Yeah. And yes, the last and the most important question is, do you love your job? Do you enjoy actually what you're doing? Or do you think that you should somehow shift to some other direction, well, as the time goes?
I love my job. So I don't have plan to change it. And of course, I recommend it young people to start looking to this direction. Because it's a perspective and actively development area.
Yeah, I can relate here. Yes, because everything we have is Do you have NLP engineers, but with some machine who have some experience in machine learning techniques? It's becoming very, very popular. And do you personally, do you think that you might shift a little bit, maybe to machine learning engineering or, AI engineering? So, or do you think that you will stick to linguistics?
I think as for me, I think I need more knowledge in machine learning, and it's more interesting for me topic in NLP than only linguistics or more linguistic tasks.
Mm-hmm. I see. Well, thanks so much for taking time to answer my questions. I know that I kind of distract you from your duties, but thank you so much for joining me today, and thanks for your honest answers. I appreciate that.
Thank you, Olga.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye.
So, to sum it up, to become a stellar natural language processing engineer, you should better be having some kind of a mathematical background or some kind of a special education, for example, in applied linguistics. But if you don't have any specialized background, meaning that you don't have any specialized education, you might still try to be an NLP engineer. And the first thing you do is to do your research. Do your research, and if you think that this is something that you will be interested in, because natural language processing engineers solve a lot of challenging tasks, and they become in more and more demand, especially if you apply machine learning techniques in your approach. And yes, if you feel that like this topic is yours and you would like to be to become a pro in this profession, then the first thing you do after the research is taking some introductory course on resources like Coursera and maybe Udemy. I haven't seen, by the way, but I believe there should be courses on NLP engineering on Udemy. I have seen on Coursera though. And after the introductory course, if you feel like it's yours, then again, do your research how you can study further. It can be, again, some advanced courses. It can be some tutorship, online tutorship included. It could be some self-education and self-educative courses and tasks that you can do. You can apply to become an intern in a software development company to work for them for free in order to gain experience and for them to master you, to teach you how to do what you would like to do, and so on and so forth. So I believe there is a way out of any situation. If you want to be someone, you can be someone. Even like I mentioned, in IT industry, your formal education doesn't really matter. Of course, Olga, she is a PhD in, I believe, in applied mathematics. I forgot to ask. I need to look through her CV. And she is, she's a lecturer in a Kharkiv State University, a Polytechnic University. And she has quite a specialized background, an academic background. But there are NLP engineers who don't have such an impressive background like Olga does. And they still work and they still produce results, and people are happy with their results. So you can as well. And coming back to the salaries questions, again, salaries in Eastern Europe and salaries in the States and salaries in Western Europe and salaries somewhere else, and maybe in Asia, they differ significantly. Like I mentioned in this video of mine, if you live somewhere around the globe, so you should apply that those rates for your location. Again, it depends on the skill that you have. If you use simple and basic rule-based approaches in your natural language processing engineering tasks, then you will pay a little bit less. If you apply some machine learning advanced techniques, then you will pay more, and so on. Now, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Sorry, today I'm speaking with you from my living room because the lighting in my home office is very lame today and you won't be able to clearly see my face, so I decided to shoot the video in my living room. I hope you don't mind. So hit the like button if you like this video, and let me know if you'd like to learn more about IT related careers. We've got big data engineers in our team, regular software engineers, DevOps engineers. So if you would like to learn more about these professions and to see more of my team members, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. I hope you have an amazing week and see you next Wednesday. Bye.